This is the story of Donald's Pooch Parlor. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this. Let's begin now. It was Saturday morning, and Donald Duck was planning a trip to the ice cream shop.
Ice cream? Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Let's see. Should I get one scoop or two? How about a French sundae or a banana split?
Dreaming of whipped cream and cherries, Donald hurried to his piggy bank.
Hey, what's the big idea? It's empty.
Then Donald remembered. Yesterday he had spent the last of his money on groceries. Once again, Donald was broke.
I need cash, and fast. Maybe Mickey can lend me some.
Donald rushed over to see his friend Mickey Mouse. When he arrived, he heard strange noises from inside the house.
Uh-oh, Mickey must be in trouble.
Donald raced inside. He followed the noises to the top of the stairs, where he saw Mickey wrestling with a shadowy figure. Donald dove into the pile.
I'll hold his arms. He'll catch his legs.
They tumbled across the floor until finally Mickey and Donald pinned him to the ground. Donald looked down to see who it was.
It's Pluto. What's going on here?
Mickey laughed sheepishly.
I was trying to catch Pluto to give him a bath, like I do every week.
Just then, Pluto wiggled out of their grasp. Donald took off after him.
He's heading downstairs, Mickey. Come on!
They chased him down the steps and over the sofa, between the bookcases and under the kitchen table. They caught up in the bathroom, where they jumped on top of him and splash! All three landed in the tub. Later, after Pluto's bath was over, Mickey handed Donald a towel.
Thanks for helping, Donald. Every week it's the same struggle. I'd give anything for some help with Pluto's grooming.
You would?
Yup. Anyway, what brings you over today?
I need some money, and I think I just found a way to do it. Thanks, Mickey.
With that, Donald hurried off. Bright and early Monday morning, Mickey's doorbell rang. He opened the door, and there was Donald with a stack of handbills.
Here you go, Mickey. It was your idea, so you get the first flyer.
Mickey read it aloud.
Announcing the grand opening of Donald's Pooch Parlor. Have your dog washed while you wait. We'll clean your collie, scrub your spaniel, pamper your Pekingese. Gee, this is great, Donald. I'll help you spread the word.
The two friends spent the rest of the morning handing out flyers all over town. Mickey wondered how many people would be interested in a pooch parlor. But the next day, when he arrived at Donald's house to help, he got his answer.
Donald, they're lined up around the block. Do you think we can handle them all?
The more the merrier, and the more money we make.
Donald's first customer was Mr. Klingheimer's bulldog, Roscoe.
Just give him to me, Mr. Klingheimer. He'll be clean in a jiffy.
Donald petted Roscoe on the head.
Nice doggy.
He led the dog to the washtub and tried to pick him up, but Roscoe had other ideas. He jumped out of Donald's arms and pulled him by the leash all around the yard. Mickey called to his friend.
Donald, let go of the leash!
Oh, yes.
He let go just as Roscoe jumped over the washtub. Mickey looked at his friend, trying hard not to laugh.
Donald, this is a dog laundry, not a duck laundry.
Fool.
By the end of the day, Mickey had helped his friend give dozens of baths, but it hadn't been easy.
You know, Donald, lots of dogs hate to be washed. They just won't sit still.
Don't worry, Mickey. They will tomorrow.
Donald spent the evening hammering and nailing in his garage. The next day, he showed Mickey what he had made. It was a dog holder, a special harness that fit over the washtub.
Now, Mickey, what do you think?
Oh, I see. The dogs stand inside the dog holder, and it keeps them from moving around. Huh, that's great, Donald, but how are you going to get them into it?
You'll see.
By 9 o'clock the next morning, the line had formed again. At the front was a Great Dane named Tiny. As Mickey led him toward the washtub, Donald stood behind the dog holder and pulled something out of his pocket. It was a hand puppet shaped like a cat. Tiny leaped over the dog holder and landed right on top of Donald. He snatched the puppet off Donald's hand and swallowed it in one quick gulp.
Oh, what do you think that is, a dog biscuit?
Mickey brightened.
Donald, that's it!
He hurried to his car and came back with a box of real dog biscuits.
Huh. I keep them in the car for Pluto, but I'll bet Tiny likes them too.
He stood behind the frame and held up one for the Great Dane to see. Tiny jumped forward and grabbed the biscuit, slipping neatly into the dog holder. Mickey buckled him in.
I guess the way to a dog's heart is through his stomach.
Using the dog holder, Donald and Mickey were able to work much faster, and they barely even got wet. As Donald counted the money that evening, his next-door neighbor, Pete, came by.
Well, neighbor, looks like business is booming. But think how much more you could do with another helper, like me, for instance.
Okay, Pete, we'll start tomorrow.
They shook on it. Donald's Pooch Parlor was only 2 days old, and already it was growing. The next day, Mrs. Van Snoot brought in her prize-winning poodle, Princely. As Mickey and Pete watched, she cautioned Donald.
Remember, his fur is very delicate.
Don't worry, we'll treat him like a prince.
20 minutes later, Princely was groomed to perfection, except for one small detail. He was green. Mrs. Van Snoot stared in horror.
This is outrageous! I'll never come to this establishment again.
That was only the beginning. Cocker spaniels mysteriously got mohawks. Pomeranians got perms, and sheepdogs got sheared. One dog looked like a porcupine, and another like a rock star. Donald pulled his new employee aside.
Be careful, Pete.
Sorry, boss. I'm trying my best.
That night, Donald lay awake worrying about his Pooch Parlor. To make matters worse, all night long there were clanking and banging noises coming from next door. The following day started out even worse. Two dogs were dyed purple and orange. A German shepherd was given perfume and a pretty pink bow. A chihuahua got tossed into the rag box and was used to sponge off the sidewalk. Donald tried to apologize.
I'm sorry, it won't happen again.
The outraged customers weren't in any mood to listen. In the confusion, Pete slipped away. A few moments later, he unveiled a strange-looking contraption in his front yard.
Step right up, folks! Bring your dogs to Pete's 5-Minute Dog Wash for high-tech, state-of-the-art grooming!
As Donald looked on helplessly, the customers stampeded out of his yard and went next door.
Please, give me another chance! Please!
But the customers weren't listening. They were too busy gaping in amazement at the handles, brushes, levers, and slings on Pete's dog washing machine. Donald stomped over to Pete.
What's the big idea? You were supposed to be helping me.
I was, neighbor. I was helping you ruin your business.
Donald slumped on the curb and watched as Pete's machine washed dog after dog, cleaning, drying, and brushing them, all in less than 5 minutes. Mickey tried to cheer up his friend.
Don't give up yet, Donald.
But, Mickey, I can't give up the Pete's machine.
Maybe you can. You've got a secret weapon, too.
Mickey smiled slyly and hurried off down the street. An hour later, he was back.
Here, Donald, your secret weapon.
What is it?
Friends, Donald, lots of them.
Around the corner came a host of familiar faces. Minnie Mouse and Daisy Duck picked up brushes and a hose. Goofy and the nephews manned the dryers. Clarabelle Cow and Horace Horsecollar headed for town to drum up business. Donald stared at them.
Mickey, did dear, when is he getting help?
Ha! Sure, Donald! Just watch!
A few of Pete's customers drifted over, and Donald's friends washed their dogs quickly and efficiently. Mrs. Hoffnagel was especially impressed.
It's wonderful to have Bowser groomed and brushed by human hands instead of by that awful machine.
Mrs. Hoffnagel was followed by others. Soon, Donald's yard was hopping again, and Pete's business had slowed to a crawl. Desperate to win back his customers, Pete cranked up his machine to run faster and faster.
Come to Pete's 3-minute, 2-minute, 1-minute dog wash.
The machine revved up to a high-pitched whine, then sputtered and died. Pete looked inside to see what was wrong. And suddenly, it started up again. It grabbed his hand and yanked him into the wash tub, where Pete was lathered, scrubbed, rinsed, and brushed. Watching from next door, Mickey turned to Donald.
Well, that should clean up his act. In the meantime, you're back in business.
Thanks, Mickey. How did I ever thank you?
Oh, gosh, Donald. Just remember, friends are always glad to help.
Mickey thought for a moment, then smiled.
But you know, Donald, you can do something for me. Would you give Pluto a bath?
That was the end of the story. If you'd like to hear it again, turn the tape over.